Dear friend, now in this particular video, we are going to discuss about what are the different good properties which required in the lubricant itself. In the last video, as we already discussed about the lubricants, its need and its basic forms. Now in this particular video, we are going to discuss about what are the different good properties which required in the lubricant itself. So this is about the properties of the good lubricants, and then we can able to use the lubricant in the case of internal combustion engine. So the first property which required in the case of lubricant, that is the viscosity. This is very important and basic property. So viscosity is a measure of the flow ability of an oil under a particular temperature and pressure. So every time if there is a need to change the oil, so always that particular mechanic will check that particular viscosity of the oil itself. If it is viscous, then there is no need to change that particular oil. If there is very low or very less viscosity is there, then always there is a need to change the oil. So viscosity is a kind of a stickiness which present inside the oil, and it should always high. It is a kind of a flow ability of oil under a particular temperature and pressure. And as per the time spent, always the viscosity of oil goes down. So this is very important and basic property of a good lubricant. Always the oil should be viscous, or the lubricant should be viscous. The second property, that is the flash point or the fire point. Flash point is also called as a fire point. So what is this? The lowest temperature at which the oil flashes and fires, known as the flash and fire point. These two temperatures must be sufficiently high for any lubricating oil to avoid a flash or burn during its use. So this is very important property which required in every lubricants. So the next one, that is a cloud. So what is the meaning of cloud? The low temperature at which the lubricant changes from the liquid state to a plastic or solid state, that is nothing but called as a cloud point. In some cases, the oil appears to be cloudy at the start of solidification. So cloud is one of the important property which required in every lubricant. The next one, that is a carbon residue. So the carbon residue is nothing but the lubricating oil being the chemical compounds of carbon and the hydrogen. When it burns, it deposits carbon on the engine parts. So this should be as low as possible for the lubricating oil. The next property, that is nothing but called as a corrosion. So what is the meaning of corrosion? So corrosion, that is nothing but a lubricant should not corrode the working parts. So always if the lubricant is having the corrosion property, then always there will be unuse of that particular lubricant. So it should be always a corrosion resistant property, or it should not corrode to the working parts. The next one, that is a pour point. So the lowest temperature at which the oil pours is called its pour point. Below this temperature, the oil becomes plastic state. So it does not produce hydrodynamic lubrication, and therefore it cannot be used below this temperature. So pour point, specific pour point is required in every lubricant. The next one, the color. So this is about the taste is not so important except for checking the uniformity of any given grade of oil. So this is again another important property which required in the lubricant. So after this one, the next one, that is the dilution of crankcase oil. Dilution is again very important for the oil. So it is nothing but the petrol vapor may escape past the piston rings during the compression stroke, which mixes with oil and affects its lubricating property. So the test which determines the amount of dilution in crankcase oil indicates that suitability of such oil itself. So always the lubricant should be dilute. That's why it is very important. The emulsification, that is nothing but a lubricant when mixed with water tend to separate. Okay, so this is very important one. The emulsification number is an index of the tendency of any oil to emulsify with water. Always the lubricant, whenever mixed with the water, it tends to separate. It's not going to mix with the water. So this is one of the very required property of every lubricant. The next one, that is oxidation at higher temperature. So the lubricating oils may break down at high temperature due to the oxidation producing hard carbon and varnish, which deposits on the engine parts. So therefore the lubricants must resist the oxidation. If it is not resist oxidation, then it is again very much harmful to the different components of the engine. That's why it is always resist oxidation. The next property, that is the evaporation. So evaporation test is conducted to find out the quantity of oil that may evaporate at high temperature. So the lubricating oil should have a low evaporation characteristic. If the lubricating oil have a more evaporation characteristic, then it will be evaporate quickly. So always it should be a low evaporation characteristic. The next one, that is the sulfur content. So the sulfur content in a corrosive form is detrimental in lubricating oil. Thus, its presence should be avoided. So this particular sulfur is directly related to the corrosion. If the quantity of sulfur is more in the lubricant, then definitely that will be corroded to the different components of the engine. So the sulfur content in a corrosive form is a detrimental in lubricating oil. So this is very important to avoid the corrosion. Then the specific gravity, which is again very important, the specific gravity of lubricating oil varies considerably, and hence it should not be regarded as the main indication of its lubricating property. And the last one, that is the neutralization number. So oil may contain impurities if not removed during refining, which have the deleterious effect on the properties of the oil. So always there is a need to remove whatever impurities are present in that particular lubricant. It should be removed with the help of a kind of a filter. So always, if you observe at the time of the maintenance of your two-wheeler or four-wheeler, there is always need to change the oil filter. So this is the basic reason to change the oil filter itself. Okay, I hope you understood the different properties of a good lubricant. So thank you so much for watching the session. Thanks a lot.